Well, the moment has passed. Back to work!
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here. Now, here's a topic that I don't talk much about, because I don't think it matters much at all. But the topic also has a lot of emotions tied to it, and it can get a lot of people very upset in TF2. Today, I want to talk about dominations. Now, the only reason it's even become relevant to me or this channel is because of their appearances in the contracts. Dominations are going to happen naturally as you play, and if you've played TF2 for any length of time, I'm sure you've had your fair amount of dominations and revenges. Either dominations on you, or perhaps you've been dominating the enemy. Now, to dominate someone, you either have to kill or assist in killing them 4 times without them scoring a kill or an assisted kill on you. Many times in my videos, I stress the importance of the objective and giving your life for a key kill, or not even caring about your life if it helps further the team's objectives. Now, this goes out the window during spooky time and around Halloween, or around an update when people are either focused more on learning the maps, completing contracts, or messing around with goofy tactics related to their new weapons from the update. So, what do you do during these times? What are the things you can do to help achieve the goals of some contracts? Now, if you're looking for dominations, the first thing you want to do above all else in seeking those dominations is to survive. The less that the enemies kill you overall is the less they will reset the 4 kill stat that you are looking to get the dominate on them. If you don't play carefully while you're doing these contracts, you could finish someone off 3 times only to have them get the assisted kill on you, resetting their personal counter for the dominate. Now, it's okay to die. This is Team Fortress 2 after all. You are expected to die in the most comical ways possible in this game. But when you do die, try to make it only from one source. A random crit death sometimes cannot be avoided. But it's double painful if that crit rocket comes from a soldier who is being healed by a medic, because it'll give both of them the kill and the assist, resetting 2 of the counters that you are wanting for your domination. The next thing we're looking for is to deal damage, or assist in other ways, because, you know, a medic's not going to cause damage for their dominate. So let's take a look at my choices for the soldier here. I'm taking a rocket launcher because it's a solid damage weapon. In the secondary, I'm taking a battalion's backup, both for its extra health, allowing me to survive longer, or when I use its rage meter up, but also because when I toot the doot, I'm going to be getting assisted kills off anyone I buff. This is great for trying to get the domination. Soldier is not the only class who can do this. For example, a scout has the milk, a sniper with his Gerardi. Pyro can easily flame many with a scorch shot, or assist with the gas passer, though its meter is slow to build. Some classes don't have great ways to assist, like the sniper. While I mentioned a Gerardi, you're probably just going to be going for headshots the whole time. Engineer probably doesn't have ways to help out except maybe throwing down a mini sentry instead of a full nest, but if you're looking for dominations, you're probably best to nest up. The spy doesn't really assist with what he does. Sure, you help teammates, but you do the whole job. You get the knife in, you get the knife out, and you get on with your life. Classes like medic being the exact opposite. He's looking for a good solid pocket, someone reliable, somebody who's gonna watch his back, to try and help get those assists for the dominations. Whatever you do, think about the class that you are. You're trying to earn dominations, which means you're trying to get the kills and the assists. So look for ways to help those around you, rather than just being the lone gunman, as it may help you to achieve the goal. Next, you want to play to your strengths. Many classes outright counter others. So don't expect to dominate a spy while you're a heavy. Now, not to say it can't happen, but that class is your direct counter. It gets clear advantages in trying to pick you off before you can get the 4 kills or assists. Just shrug those deaths off. Now instead, the heavy should be staring down the pyros. the pyros often want to get into the range that the heavies love to engage in. They cannot reflect bullet, and they will have to try and sustain fire while being mowed down by your minigun. Likewise, an engineer is going to have a really hard time trying to get a dominate on a sniper. Anytime you poke your head out, it's going to go missing from your shoulders, and I don't expect the engineers to try and wrangle their sentry to pick off the snipers outside of their sentry range. Let those deaths and those kills just slide off your back like a knife off an Uber charge. They don't matter towards your overall goal. Now, if you're going to be so lucky as to have a medic on your team, work with them. There's no better way to stay alive and survive better than protecting your pocketed medic. They are actively looking to help you as you're actively looking to help them and to help your teammates. So do your best to try and help them stay alive, and they will help you in your goal towards your dominations. If you are caught in a low health situation, try to minimize the impact towards your dominations as possible. Try to keep that kill to the one damage source. Shoot, if possible, consider killing yourself if you're in a low health situation. If you have engaged the enemy, have no way of healing, and you are behind their lines, use the console kill command to explode yourself. Or, you know, damage yourself with your own weapons, or kill yourself off with a map hazard. Be careful to space out the damage you do to yourself from the last damage source so you don't credit them with the kill. The last thing we want to do is reset their kill counter. Look out for the round being over. If your team wins, this is great! Kill any kill that can add to the counter. Try and land damage on as many of them as you can for the kills and assists. But if you do suffer a loss in a round, don't worry about it, as your goal of this moment is not to win or lose maps, but to get the dominations to help your contract. Games are not normal right now. In between people learning the new maps, messing around with their new weapons, playing classes they're not familiar with in order to complete contracts, all of it has made everything a little bit zany, okay? Don't get too tied up with the normal paradigms of trying to win or lose the maps, especially from this channel where I tell you you should sell yourself out to try and win maps. It's just not a time for it. Play for fun. This is the most fun time that ever happens in TF2. Things get way goofy, things get way strange, the weirdest things happen. You just gotta roll with it. Good luck on your contracts. I hope you're doing well. I hope you unlock all your skins and get all the bonus items that you possibly can. This is Team Fortress 2 at its most fun and its most casual. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Non più dry farfalon amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento ad un cibo d'amor.